6:45 sounds better. It's Wednesday, May 27th. This is 104.3 MyFM. It is Valentine in the morning.
We've been talking about the foods that we are all sick of in quarantine. 31043 is the text line. Ben said, Chipotle. I can't resist that darn free delivery. It's just too easy. Have you been using that, Joe?
No, that's... Yes, free delivery. And then they have that new queso blanco, too, which is so good. It's at least twice a week for me.
Wow. Denise said, pasta. Why did we buy so much pasta? And then this text, it just slipped in here. Honestly, this is real. It says, I would eat Valentine for dessert. I just wanted to read that. Adam said, my wife bought...
Wait. I'm not joking. You can't just go past that.
That's all there is to it.
That's all there is to it?
There's no name. There's no
guy,
name.
Guy, girl, do we know? Nothing.
I don't know anything. Okay. Sorry. I'll send you the number. Adam said, my wife bought humongous containers of rice. It's going to take us a year to eat it all. I'm already sick of it. And then Shauna said, I'm just sick of my own cooking. I can't wait to go to a restaurant. And the whole thing, this whole survey that we were talking about earlier, it said that 90% of people surveyed said they're looking forward to being able to go to a restaurant again, with Mexican being the top choice.
Yeah, I get that. I get a big thing of rice in the garage, too. We had to put it in a container and make sure no mice or anything get in like that. And it's probably some massive, like, 20-pound bag of rice or something. I'm like, what am I doing? You know, and then I also, when I first started, went to Costco and I got all these beans. I get, like, rice and beans. I call it beans or protein. They don't go bad. They're in cans. So apparently I was preparing for the apocalypse or something. But like everybody else, you didn't know. Just grab stuff. Right. And now I got to slowly start working rice and beans into every meal if I ever want to get rid of that stuff.
Yeah, exactly.
For fresh fruit, I was thinking, what am I going to do with fresh fruit? So I got a case of pineapple. I don't like pineapple. I've got like all these cans of pineapple in the garage because I figured it had vitamin C. That was my theory.
Oh, I love pineapple.
So do I.
I'll bring you guys a can of pineapple next time I see you.
How about that? That much.
Let's do first sipper. What's first sip all about, Kevin?
First sip is a chance for everybody to start the day on a positive note, which is sorely needed these days. Valentine shares a few inspirational words. At the end of it, we all raise our cups high, whatever you drink in the morning to get you moving. We all toast the day ahead and have that first sip together.
You know what? I bet there's some people out there that when they look at you, you think you're a bit nuts, you're a bit crazy, you're a bit, you know, off your rocker, so to speak. You've got some dreams that might stand out to them as nuts and unachievable. And you've got just the way you live your life sometimes that relatives and family and friends look at and go, my gosh, what is wrong with you? You're crazy. You're a nut job. Let me tell you something about you. I think you are unique. What an amazing thing that is to be. To be unique, to be different from the person next to you. Stand out in the crowd sometimes is absolutely stunningly amazing. And that could be you. In fact, you know what? Even if you think you're somebody that blends in with the crowd, you're not. There's something about you that is so incredibly special. So when people tell you you're nuts, you're crazy, you're bonkers, you're whatever you are, the best people in life truly are. So if you're off your rocker a bit, if you don't conform in all the areas that people want you to conform in, you're amazing. You're awesome. You're astounding. You're astonishingly, I'm using all the A's. I've been inside the thesaurus now, I guess. You're really, really an awesome person. Don't be afraid of being different. For some of you going into work, I'm sure, you know, you do the same thing every day. You just do what you do to get by. Don't be afraid of being different. It's only one time in this merry-go-round of life. Be who you want to be inside. And some of you are taking this in all different ways right now as these words come out of my mouth. But honestly, sun shines up in Southern California. Be who you want to be. You're unique. You're special. Count us up, Joe.
1, 2, 3.
Ryan, I'm looking right at you. You are unique. You are special. You should be who you want
to
be.
Talking to me that whole time. I knew it.
I'm on FaceTime. I gotta look at somebody to make eye contact. Give me like a man.
Kissing on this shawty, she don't be kissing on me. She came with you to live with me. I was up a point, that's called it even. Don't like the car, she ain't gonna find her new things. That girl know what she wants, she made me take it off, she see me. She say I make a whatever my face pop up on TV. I had to say no, this week, gotta do it safer, you can keep it. 5-star, I'm fresh about the trap and I'm going fever. She know I'm a call away, she drop a pin and I come meet her. Stand next to me, you're gonna catch the fever.
Oh,
Camila Cabello, Da Baby. My oh my. It's 104.3 MyFM, it's Valentine in the morning. Do you guys know much about Da Baby?
I don't.
I know the name and I know that song. I'm Googling him feverishly right now to try and find out more.
I love that song.
He likes to wear a hat.
Great. Da Baby likes to wear a hat.
28 years old, he's from Cleveland. His real name is Jonathan Kirk.